अस्सलाम वालेकुम प्री नाइन क्लास, सब्जेक्ट कंप्यूटर साइंस। होप यू आर ऑल फाइन स्टूडेंट्स। यूनिट नंबर वन, प्रॉब्लम सॉल्विंग। इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट द फ्लो चार्ट्स एंड द इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑफ फ्लो चार्ट्स। नाउ टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आवर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक, दैट इज 1.2.3 एंड इट्स ऑन पेज नंबर 7, डिटर्मिनिंग रिक्वायरमेंट्स फॉर अ फ्लो चार्ट। इन अ फ्लो चार्ट वी यूज इनपुट आउटपुट डिसीजन मेकिंग एंड प्रोसेसिंग। These concepts are described in the following: input means taking data from a user, processing it and give some output as shown in figure 1.7. For a flow chart, the requirements are to know about. Students, in a flow chart we use four steps, that includes input, output, decision making and processing. First one is inputs. Input means taking data from the user. It is important to know how many and what type of inputs are required. Students, input means taking data from the user, and it is very essential to know how many and what type of data is needed. Second one is processing. A flow chart also contains processing steps. The processing steps are used for performing calculations and storing the results of calculations. These may include increasing or decreasing a value, adding or multiplying or dividing two values, etc. Students, a flow chart also comprises processing stages. The processing steps are used for the execution of calculations, and then it stores the results of calculations, and these calculations may contain increasing or decreasing, adding or multiplying or dividing the two values. Third one is decision making. To determine whether a statement is true or false and taking appropriate steps accordingly is called decision making. To find out whether a statement is true or false and then taking proper steps accordingly, that is called decision making. Fourth one is outputs. Outputs are used to display information, and usually this information exhibits the processed results. Students, outputs are used to show the information, and generally this information represents the processed results. So students, in today's lecture we have learned about the requirements for a flow chart, and it contains input, output, processing and decision making. You have to learn page number 7 half. Take care of yourself. Allah Hafiz.